Race 6, top of the stretch, run for the money, payback, Mill Pond Cheyenne, Aviana, Time Old Charmer, and a tough little guy. They're off and pacing, run for the money, in at the rail, away in search of the early lead. Payback will get away second, outside third, that's Mill Pond Cheyenne, Aviana unhurried in four, and back fifth at the rail is Time Old Charmer, the early trailer, a tough little guy. Field of six heads on into the Redland Farms backstretch for the first time as they continue on to the opening panel. Run for the Money has opened up a 2.5-3-length lead on Payback, who's in pursuit second. Third inside is Mill Pond Cheyenne. Aviana back there pacing in four, followed closely by Time Old Charmer from five and sixth, and still at the back is a tough little guy. No change in positions. They're still single file, making their way past the 3/8. Opening quarter was paced in 28 4/5 seconds. Off the turn and in front of the grandstand now, they come for the first time, approaching the half, led by Run for the Money. Up on the outside now, attacking first over. Here comes Mill Pond Cheyenne to challenge for the lead. Staying in the pocket is Payback third. Outside following cover, Aviana is looking at it from four. Fifth and moving in the outside third over is a tough little guy now trailing. That's Time Old Charmer. Three in, three out as they head to the Redland Farms backstretch. Final time, 59 1/5 second was the half. Run for the Money holds the lead half a length. Outside Mill Pond Cheyenne second. Aviana well spotted in the second overpath. Down on the inside, Payback getting a good trip, but will need some racing room as they travel past the 3/4 mile mark. Mill Pond Cheyenne and Run for the Money continuing to battle for the lead. Aviana sits patient on the outside, a third inside, a Payback is fourth. Then a gap of 3 lengths back. Fifth is Time Old Charmer to the outside, a tough little guy. They race past the 7/8 and Run for the Money is holding the lead. Now here comes Aviana, forced three high around a tiring Mill Pond Cheyenne. 1:29 was the 3/4. Down the stretch they come. It's Run for the Money. Aviana down the center of the track. Outside Aviana, inside is Run for the Money. Run for the Money and Aviana. Run for the Money, holding to win it by 3/4 of a length over Aviana and Mill Pond Cheyenne. Mile and 1:59 1/5. Mastow Market Pace winner. Run for the money now back in the Woodmere Farms at Winners Enclosure. She's a three-year-old daughter of sports writer out of the Better's Delight Dam Pia Hanover. By Full House Racing of Truro, trained by George Renison. Todd Trites picking up his second winning drive of the afternoon. Run for the money with a new lifetime best of 159 and one-fifth. Race six is official. One run for the money. The winner, two payback fourth, three Milpon Cheyenne third, four was scratched, five Aviana second, six Time Old Charmer fifth, seven A Tough Little Guy six, and eight was scratched. Quarter was 28-4, the half 59-1, three quarters and 129. The mile four run for the money, a new mark of 159 1/5. From the top, 1-4-3 scratched, 2-5-6 scratched. 1-5-3 try and race 6, $94.30. The 1-5 exactor, $28.90. And the $1 superfecta, 1-5-3-2. It returned $108.40. Seventh race is up next. No changes in race 7. 8 starters with post time in less than 5 minutes.
Welcome back. Off an impressive looking win for Run for the Money. So congratulations to Scott Green and George Renison and Company on their victory in race number 6. As we turn it over to race number 7, which is the Acropole Pizza and Donaire Pace. I think that's the favorite for a lot of trainers here at Truro.
Absolutely.
They like that one. But in this case, as we look at the handicapper selections, Sugar and Grady both in on Tobin's Reward, who's the 5-2 choice in the morning line. And then Melissa Keith going to the outside, Whistlin' Cricket, looking for a price. And she's going to get a price on Whistlin' Cricket, who comes off a 157.4 mile last time out. 14 starts, has one win, just one on the board finish. That would be a horse that's going to pay some money, and Melissa's looking for a price here.
Yeah, absolutely. And that mare is currently 13-1. I like this mare a lot. Dave Carey's in the barn beside us. The dam's really produced a lot of nice mares. It's a long ways out there, but this is a mare that kind of just plugs along. You see she does have a win back on July 9th in 59. She's set up close, so we'll see how close she can get here and how forward position Greg gets her. But this is one of those catch-all classes as well, and I think she's got as good a chance as anybody. I've actually got her third in my try selection.
And in here, I like number 5, Daddy's Eyes, who Sugar and Grady have on the edges of their ticket in third. And Daddy's Eyes, you know, has been racing against better horses than this group, in my humble opinion, and was second. Raced really well at the Island during Old Home Week, second by 3/4, and that 157.2 was very, very sharp effort there. But, has been competitive here as well, and I'm looking for this one to take a step forward today.
Yeah, I like this horse. I've got him on top of my try as well. One of the things I do look at here, though, Jamie's driven him 3 times now. They haven't gotten along super well. You see a 6th place 5th, a 6th, and then that break behind the gate a couple of starts ago. So we'll see if they can get along a little bit better here today. But at 5-1, I think he's got a real shot here for Rachel and Jamie.
All right, let's send it outside for Joe and the post parade. We'll be back after that.
Parading are the 7th race entries, an Acropole Pizza and Denier Pace. Number 1 is Gondro Machine, owned by Linda and Leslie Parker, with Kenny Parker up. Roger Matthews Renison owns and drives the 2 entries, Salzburg Flicka. Keith Lag for Monolag aboard 3, Crafty Example. Brent Boucher, Fred Saunders, co-owners. Todd Trites, the driver of 4, Tobin's Reward. Daddy's Eyes has post 5, owned by Rachel McDonald, driven today by Jamie Ramsey. Ernie Laughlin for Michelle Patrick in with 6, Fifth Estate. Greg Monroe will pot at Whistlin' Cricket from post 7. Owners are Heather Gaddy, Gail Skelhorn, Margaret Hobson, and Gloria Carey. Rounding out the field from the trailing post 8, Reggie's Game, with Clara McDonald at the lines for Donna Wilson. That's the field for race 7, post time in less than 3 minutes.
Steve Fitzsimmons, Brad McCollum back with you as we handicap race number 7 upcoming, the Acropole Pizza and Donaire Pace. And you get a look at Tobin's Reward. No, I'm sorry, that's Whistlin' Cricket. And Greg Monroe, the Dave Carey trainee, and certainly off the last line, the fastest by far in this field. And And certainly Mel Keith is liking this one, and at 17 to 1, certainly the payoff would be handsome.
Yeah, absolutely. This is Mel's first choice here.